Hey guys, my name is Stuart Clark. I'm one of the lead instructors here at the Sea Dresser Golf Academy. Today's tip is when and how to use different wedges. Now, previous in some of my instructions, we talked about short game, hitting out a thicker rough or tight lies. Well, today, we're gonna talk about flighting the ball. And how we flight the ball is not necessarily like taking the ball and putting it way back in our stance. If we have a lie that is sitting here on a nice tight lie, we never want to put the ball back in our stance because that changes that angle of attack of being steep. If I'm wanting to hit a low shot, I'm just going to change the club to a wedge or 9 or 8 and keep the ball position still middle to forward. When we have these nice tight lies in the fairways, we never want to get those balls working back in our setup because once again, that angle attack's down, that's chunks and skulls. When we have the ball middle to middle forward on these angles, and when we're changing these clubs, we keep it constant, we have an opportunity to be a little off and still hit good shots. So if I'm wanting to hit a higher shot, I'm going to use my 56 and open it up a little bit and do the same thing, keep everything the same, pitch it, get a higher ball flight, say what that's a 2 for me. I use 1 for low, 2 mid, 3 high. For a lower flight, I just walk right over here, keep everything the same, grab my pitching wedge, which is a 46 degree, keep everything constant the same, keep the weight left. Now this ball is going to shoot a little lower because I've got less loft. So do the same kind of deal. Take the weight left, rock the shoulders, boom. Now that ball's coming off on a lower trajectory. So we don't necessarily, when we're changing trajectories, let's keep the ball positioned the same and not move it all over the place. Okay? Tip for today.